Good afternoon and welcome faculty, family, and friends to the class of 2020's graduation ceremony. My name is Kelsey Harris, your senior class president, and it is an honor to be speaking in front of you here today. On behalf of class of 2020, we would like to thank you for all your love and support you've given us over the years, and without you, we wouldn't have come this far. When I was preparing to write this speech, I put it off. Not because I would get emotional in front of you, which may happen, but because I truly cannot believe the day that we've all been waiting for is finally here. The day we've all worked so hard for, and the day we finally say goodbye to WHS. We were all running away from our small town and peers that we've hated for so long, but now we are realizing that we've created a family over time. Senior year went by faster than we would have hoped, and now we're clutching onto endless laughter, hanging out with our classmates, and every last moment that's familiar. In a few short months, we will be expected to look back and say, this is the past, but I'm telling you to hold on to every last moment of senior year. Do things that make you happy and live. I'm going to share a verse with you. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Deuteronomy 31:6. Graduation is a time to remember and a time to dream, a time to look back and a time to reach forward, a time for songs of laughter and tears of joy, a time for letting go and a time for discovering hopes and dreams that are yet to come, a time to say goodbye to yesterday and greet tomorrow with courage, a time for loving hearts to gather and a time to celebrate all that you are and all that you will become. I'd like to give a special thanks to a few people in my life. Thank you, Ms. Gathan, for always believing in me. You have been one of the most encouraging people in my life. I'd like to give thanks to my teachers over the years for me to be standing up here today. You had to do something right. I'd like to thank my mom, my dad, my Nana, and my papa, Raven and MJ, for always pushing me to do well in other things. I love you guys. I want to thank my best friend, Casey Killam, for getting me through the good times and the bad ones. My last thank you goes to my class. Thank you guys for making the past 4 years of Warner High School so special. From the first week of high school and the senior parade to the box hunt to getting a little bit rowdy in Mr. Mann's class and everything in between, you all made each day worthwhile and your company will be sorely missed as we move on. With this extraordinary chapter of our lives coming to an end, I'm certain that we all will want to skip the pages to see what happens next. Luckily, as WHS graduates, we have been given all of the paper and ink we need to write our own stories. And with the love and support from our families, friends, and fellow graduates, our stories will be bestsellers. Thank you.
Members of the Board of Education, members of the faculty, parents, and other guests, and members of the graduating class of 2020, it is my privilege to make the following introductions. School board members, Mr. Jerry Daniels, president. Dr. Carrie Pennington, vice president. Ms. Angela Marshall, secretary. Mr. Shannon Gorman. Mr. Greg Mormon. Mr. Joey Cathy. Mr. Joel Tolfrey. And principal of Warren High School, Ms. Tiffany Gathan.
Hello, and good afternoon to everyone who is able to attend with us today in these very strange and difficult times. I would like to start off by saying thank you to the staff of Warren School District for organizing this event for us. In a year that has been full of postponements, cancellations, and disappointments, this event really means a lot to the seniors graduating this year. I will keep my speech brief because this year we have 4 valedictorians and 2 salutatorians, which is a very good problem to have. I would like to thank all of the people who helped not only myself, but also the rest of the class of 2020 get to where we are today. I speak for the entire class of 2020 when I say thank you to our teachers, custodians, administration, lunch ladies, and librarians for always helping us to succeed and achieve our dreams. Without you, there would be no class of 2020 to celebrate. I would also like to thank all of my friends for always pushing me to be the best person I can be, and for being some of the most dependable people I've ever met. I miss you guys so much, and I hope I see you all soon. Out of the many things I learned during my time at Warren High School, The value of friendship is by far the most important. As the old Irish proverb goes, a good friend is like a four-leaf clover, hard to find and very lucky to have. If that is the case, then I'm one of the luckiest guys in the world. And I really appreciate everyone who's here, everyone who's not able to be here. Thank you all for always being there for me throughout my high school career. As I conclude, I would like to say one last thank you to the most important people in my life, my family. Thank you all for giving me so many opportunities, not only over the past couple years, but throughout my entire life, and for your never-ending support. It really means a lot to me, and I'm so lucky to have the family that I do. And speaking of family, I made a promise to my grandfather when I was younger, I would bow after I gave my speech at graduation. So if you don't mind, I have a promise to keep and a stage to walk one last time. Thank you all. Please stay safe.
Parents, family, faculty and staff, friends, those who are watching this on computer screens, and most of all, the remarkable class of 2020. What an amazing occasion tonight is for our class, and what an unusual, unpredictable ending to this 2020 school year has been. I should be used to speaking to large groups of people, considering I have read the WHS announcements for the last 3 years, but I find that saying the Pledge of Allegiance and reading the lunch menu is a little different than speaking to a large group of people about the best few years of my life so far. So please, bear with me. This has been an unusual year, and this is an unusual graduation, but the class of 2020 is an unusual class. Since I can remember, the day everyone has most looked forward to was graduation. We could hardly wait. Now the day is here, and even though it is not exactly how we imagined it to be, it does not change the fact that we are graduating. We did it, and we have just begun. We know that graduating is just the beginning. We will now take the hard-learned life lessons and skills Warren High School taught us and use them to work towards our next goal. The last 4 years were a long road that I could not have traveled alone. I'm standing here today giving this speech because of the people who helped me along the way. So it is important to take the time to give credit where credit is due. First, I thank God, because if it were not for Him, none of us would be here today. He gave me strength in times of need and guided me down the right path to take. Next, I thank my parents and family. They supported every decision that I have made and pushed me to strive to achieve every goal I set for myself. To my friends, thank you for all the spontaneous trips and adventures that will now be very seldom since our ways are now parting. To my Honey Bun Club, I will miss all the nights we rode around screaming Colin Baton Rouge at the top of our lungs, the El Palacio dates, the self-timer pictures, and doing Chinese fire drills. To Jay Saunders, one of my closest friends, thank you for being my involuntary photographer my senior year and willing to drive wherever and do whatever for me. And to Riley Griffin, who was a sister I never had, and my second family in DeWitt, thank you. Although they live over an hour away, they have helped me help shape me into the person I am today with all their love and support. I have found my true friends during high school. They are some of my biggest blessings, and I know for a fact I would not be standing here today if it were not for them. Now on to softball. Most everyone knows softball has been a huge part of my life for the last 10 years. Many of the best memories I have are related to softball. I will never forget all the parties on the bus ride home, eating Chicken Express, hitting moonshots, and everything in between. Even the serious, heart-to-heart conversations we had quite often. Thank you, Coach Bart Goodwin, Coach Kyle Wagner, and Coach Bo Hembry for taking a softball team that was 0-24 my freshman year. Yes, you heard it correctly, 0-24, and helping us go technically undefeated my senior year. These coaches taught me life lessons on and off the field that I will carry with me throughout life, even though my softball career has ended. Also, Coach Bart, I'm still sorry for shattering your iPhone junior year. I promise it was a complete accident, and I couldn't do it again if I tried. Warren High School has the best faculty and staff. One of my favorite people there is Miss Tiffany Gathan. I don't know where to start to thank Miss Gathan. I will cherish all the mornings I spent in her office talking to her and everything that she did for me. Miss Gathan always listened to my problems and put every student's best interest first. She is someone who I will miss very much. Also, thank you to Miss Heidi Lassiter and Miss Joanna Young. I often ask myself, what would I have done at WHS without them? These two women were like second moms to me at the school. To the rest of the WHS amazing faculty and staff, I thank each of you for always trying your hardest to help us in every way possible and for trying to make sure we had the academic tools we needed for the future. You have given us academics, but you have also let us create memories of fun and laughter that we will always cherish. Finally, I thank the class of 2020. These are the people who I have grown up with, made countless memories with, and now the ones that I'm having to say goodbye to. As I stand here today, I ask myself, where have the years gone? It seems as just yesterday we were going on the pumpkin patch field trip at Eastside, making our 100 days of school shirts, or getting ready for Rise and Shine ceremonies. When trying to think of the most memorable times I've had with my classmates, a few things come to mind, such as taking the box competition and turning it into a complete war between each grade to see who could collect the most boxes, or the pep rallies in the cultural center when we would win the spirit stick, and always making sure we had the best homecoming week costumes. I will miss not being a part of any more box competitions, pep rallies, or homecoming weeks. Most of all, I will miss my classmates that were there to pick me up when I was down and the ones who could make me laugh until I cry, even on my worst days. Our days of skipping class to go to the library or walk in circles in the hallway to waste time are over. We are now here in our cap and gowns about to receive our diploma. We will go our separate ways to meet again down the road of life. As a graduation gift, someone gave me a Dr. Seuss's graduation speech, which I loosely quote as my final words as a Warren High School student. Congratulations, today is our day. We're off to great places, we're off and away. We have brains in our head, we have feet in our shoes. We can steer ourselves any direction we choose. And oh, the places we'll go, class of 2020. I wish you all the best of luck on your future endeavors. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Mark Hurston and I am representing the Warren High School class of 2020 as one of this year's valedictorians. I first want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who died on an old wooden cross so that I might have eternal life. Also, I would like to thank my parents, who have worked so hard to provide for me and guide me to follow Christ, as well as work hard in everything I do. Thank you, and I love you all very much. To my Mama and Papa, Mama and Granddad, thank you for your guidance and love you have shown me all these years, and being the best grandparents anyone could ask for. I would also like to thank three teachers that left a lasting mark on my life, who helped me to desire a good education and pushed me to be the best and brightest person I can be. They're Miss LaDonna Marsh, Miss Tina Kearley, and Miss Barbara Benton. These three ladies taught me discipline and to never give up. Thank you all very much. Thank you to all my coaches who spent hours upon hours preparing game plans and training us in a way so that we had some of the most successful teams here at Warren High School. I had such great memories here at Warren High, but some of the greatest were with the Warren High School football and baseball teams. On the gridiron, it was storming the field after defeating Joe T. Robinson 35-28 in overtime to send us to the state championship. On the baseball diamond, it was stumping Monticello 9-8 my junior year. To all the faculty and staff at Warren High School, Superintendent Cornish, Ms. Gathan, from all the class of 2020, we cannot say thank you enough for taking all efforts to make this day possible, especially during one of the most trying times our world has ever seen. I do not have to go into what is going on in our world today, but there is something very ironic about the entire situation we are dealing with. You all know the coronavirus pandemic has wreaked havoc throughout our world. What is so unique to me is that my great-grandmother, Ray Carter, was born in 1900. When she was 18 years old, like myself, her generation was met with the Spanish flu pandemic of 1918. Only 4 years earlier, they had gone through World War I and its death-defying modern warfare. At the time, their futures were looking very bleak. From the Spanish flu pandemic came Black Tuesday and the stock market crash, creating a Great Depression throughout the 1930s. Time marches on into the late 1930s to the mid-1940s, and their generation saw the Second World War. From the surprise attacks from Japanese forces at Pearl Harbor to the harrowing amphibious attacks on the beaches of Normandy, we saw our soldiers struggle for our nation's freedom. Then we go a little further in time into the early 1950s, where many men died on Korean soil for the hope that communism would not spread. This was also seen in the heroic but costly years of the mid-1960s to the mid-1970s in Vietnam, when terrible onslaught ensued for the cause of, again, trying to prevent communism. My great-grandmother and her generation saw the world at some of its darkest moments, but there's a positive to this story. We can get so caught up in the bad that we never see the good. This generation saw the invention of the assembly line production of automobiles, the first airplane, availability of indoor plumbing and television, as well as vaccine for smallpox and the air conditioning. They were the generation that even put the first man on the moon. So we sit here today, a class who came into the world greeted by the cataclysmic events of 9/11, followed by years of modern terrorism, a deep economic recession of 2008, the Boston Marathon bombing, school shootings, and now the great coronavirus pandemic. In what seems for us no hope, no future, what do we turn to? We must take a step back and look at what the generation of my great-grandmother did. They were met with problem after problem, but they looked towards the face of Almighty God for guidance and realized that none of their power to overcome their problems came from themselves, but through Him. Their obstacles were great, but the things that came after their struggle showed the grit and fortitude that came with their generation. So for the class of 2020, what shall we do? Shall we cower from the world as we enter this new chapter of life, or meet it with God's unwavering power? Will we rise to this occasion and be the men and women we were trained to be? Will we return to our principles of faith and morals that birthed the nation that the world had never seen before? My friends, we now have a decision to take our stance on life, on our country, to shape our future for us, our children, and our children's children. What will be our first automobile, our first airplane, and our first moon landing? As I close, I want to leave you with a quote from the late President Ronald Reagan. He said, "And without God, democracy will not and cannot long endure." If we ever forget that we're one nation under God, then we will be a nation gone under. He said this because he knew what it would take for our country to sustain through prosperous times and perilous times. We appear to be facing some tough times ahead, but I know as the class of 2020, we will remain focused and engaged to get through such troubling times. John 16:33 says, "These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." Have faith, everyone. Just hold on and have faith. Once again, thank you, Warren High School, for all the good memories. As a representative of the class of 2020, it is our duty to make you proud and be the leaders of tomorrow. We will not let you down. God bless you. God bless America. God bless the class of 2020, and go Jacks.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anissa Henry, and I'm one of Warren High School's valedictorians this year. I know by now you are probably tired of listening to speeches, considering I'm giving speech number 5 and there are still 2 left, but I hope I can keep your attention and not bore you all too bad. I want to start off by giving God all the glory because I wouldn't be where I am today without Him. I also want to acknowledge and thank my parents for all their love and support they have shown me throughout my years of school. I'm so blessed to have them in my life, and I hope that I can be half as good as they are to me. And now to commence my speech. No matter how much you think you hate school right now, you will miss at least one aspect of it, whether it be your best friend, a sport you play, or it may be a club that you're in. For me, it'll be a little bit more than that. It'll be the pep rallies before a big game, watching the nail-biter football games that would make or break the season. It'll be playing softball for the Lady Jacks and singing Flashlight from Pitch Perfect to the top of our lungs on the bus ride home. I'll miss throwing discus for the track team, and I'll miss those tennis matches that turned into barbecues and tailgating thanks to some dedicated fans. I'll miss walking across the stage at the Cultural Center feeling like a princess on the homecoming court, and those basketball games that got intense between the close scores and the student sections bad-mouthing one another. I'll definitely miss the honey buns in the vending machine at the teacher's lounge. All the office workers know that those things would smack any time of the day. And I will miss playing shell shockers in the virtual lab and listening to everyone get mad about it. Driving around town getting PTSD from seeing a pile of cardboard boxes was something I never thought I'd have, but WHS proved me wrong. I love getting together with my classmates to do whatever was necessary to make sure we won the box competition. By the way, still waiting on that pizza party. Even though WHS gave me some of the best days of my life, it also gave me some pretty rough ones, like going 0-24 in softball my freshman year. Yeah, I will not miss that. And while I'm on the subject of softball, Coach Bo, I never rolled my eyes at you at that one softball practice. I will not miss giving up a Saturday morning to take the ACT, and I will no longer have to stress over public speaking or my college Spanish classes. Thank goodness for that. I also won't have to worry about walking a mile just to get to my CBET classes. Everything I endured at WHS gave me a valuable life lesson in return. Like, don't take boxes from Dollar General without asking, or they will call corporate. Don't accidentally hit your softball coach in the face with a tennis ball, or you will no longer be the favorite Lady Jack. I also learned that being cold is only mental and not because of the actual 20-degree weather, according to Coach Bo Hembree, and that the library was a great place for a nap during lunch. Not to mention that dog noises during class were enough to drive any teacher insane. I'm truly thankful for all of these life lessons that were learned along the way. Although the lessons were few compared to what is to come, I'm truly humbled I had the opportunity of making these memories with you all. Class of 2020, I hate we didn't get to finish this year off, but the way I see it is we can either dwell on the moments we missed out on or celebrate the ones we did have. Yes, we didn't have the traditional senior year, but in my opinion, we had the most memorable. Everyone will remember the class of 2020 for years to come, and that is something to cherish. As I begin to close my speech, I would like to give thanks to a few more people, starting with a few of my coaches. Coach Sawyer, Coach Janice Reddick, Coach Kyle Wagnon, and Coach Bart Goodwin. Thank you all for coaching me in some of the best sports there are and for teaching me lessons both in and out of sports. I will be forever grateful for the life lessons taught through tennis, track, and most importantly, softball. Softball was more than just a sport to me. It's something that gave me some of my best friends and fondest memories. It taught me things I never knew I needed to know, and I will hold that in my heart forever. I would also like to give thanks to Mr. Stephen Quose for being such an influential teacher and advice giver. Mr. Quose would do anything for his students and was always there whenever any of us needed him. So thank you, Quose, for supporting the class of 2020 like you did as our teacher, 10th and 11th grade. And thank you, Ms. Tiffany Gathan, for being such a great role model and a supportive person. You've helped me out so much this school year, and I will miss coming to talk to you, making jokes with you, and asking you for a little guidance. So thank you, Warren High School, for the good times, the bad times, and all those times in between. To the rest of my classmates, I want to leave you with this excerpt from Grey's Anatomy. Today's the day our lives begin. Today we become citizens of the world. Today we become grown-ups. Today we become accountable to someone other than ourselves and our parents. Accountable for more than our grades. Today we become accountable to the world, to the future, to all the possibilities that life has to offer. Starting today, our job is to show up wide-eyed and willing and ready. For what? I don't know. For anything. For everything. To take on life, to take on love, to take on the responsibility and the possibility. Today, my friends, our lives begin, and I, for one, can't wait. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, faculty, guests, and alumni. My name is Samantha Evans, and I'm one of the salutatorians this year. I want to thank you for being part of the graduation ceremony for the Warren High School class of 2020. I also want to thank you for your support over the past 13 years. It is no secret that teenagers can be trying at times. Add a pandemic to the mix and things can spin out of control quickly. For now, let's not focus on that. First, I would like to thank God because there is no way I would be standing here today without Him. If you know me, you know that speaking in front of a group terrifies me. He is the reason I am able to give this speech. Next, I would like to thank my family and friends for your support and for pushing me to do my best. I would also like to thank the teachers that I've had over the past years for their dedication and encouragement. It would take hours to thank each and every person who impacted my life. Instead, I will leave you with this. Life is uncertain and unpredictable, so live each day like it's your last. By that, I don't mean be reckless and selfish. I mean embrace change, challenge yourself to be the best you can be, and leave the world a little bit better than you found it. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Braden Jones, and right now, I should be hanging out with friends and making memories on Panama City Beach. Instead, COVID-19 ended our senior year, taking away our last days at Warren High School and my senior season of Lumberjack baseball. However, I am not bitter. Instead, I, like the rest of you, have chosen to persevere, knowing that better days lie ahead. During this pandemic, we have experienced unique and oftentimes difficult circumstances. And as cliche as it sounds, when the going gets tough, the tough must get going. Persevering through these troubling times is all that we can do. Thankfully, I learned about perseverance during my sophomore year when we lost to Arkadelphia in the 2017 4A state football championship game. Even though our team had played our hearts out all season, we suffered a devastating one-point defeat in the state championship game, and that loss hurt so bad. Although this game is one of the most heartbreaking experiences I have encountered, it taught me that perseverance is a necessity in life. Instead of wallowing in self-pity, the Lumberjacks accepted defeat and began working towards our next season. So, when hard times come our way, and I know they will, we must always work through the obstacles in front of us, believing that better days can and will come. In an interview published in Psychology Today, Maya Angelou said, "You see, we may encounter many defeats, but we must not be defeated. It may be necessary to encounter the defeat so that we can know who we are, so that we can see, oh, that happened, and I rose. I did get knocked down flat in front of the whole world, and I rose. I didn't run away, I rose right where I had been knocked down." Our senior year might not have ended the way that we wanted it to, but we are blessed beyond measure that we received an education from the Warren School District that will propel us into the future. I plan to take the many lessons that every teacher, coach, administrator, and staff had presented to me these last 13 years and make a good life for myself. And I hope you all do the same too. May we never forget where we have come from and those who have always stood by our sides. Class of 2020, may we always keep on keeping on. Go Jacks!
Mr. Cornish, I present to you the class of 2020. This class has met all requirements of the Arkansas Department of Education.
Class of 2020, it is an honor to stand before you today as the superintendent of the Warren School District. I would like to thank our parents for allowing the Warren School District the opportunity to provide your child's education. I am extremely excited for each of you and wish all of you the best of luck in the future. Please do not let these challenges that we face today be a deterrence on whatever it is you choose to do in life. These are only challenging times that we will eventually overcome. I always stand before the graduating class and say there will be challenging times in the future, and how you respond to these challenges will define you as a person. Class of 2020, you have the advantage of on other classes. You are experiencing very challenging times at this time. I encourage you not to let these times define you as a person. Instead, accept the challenges that has been dealt and make the best of it. I can remember in 2016, when we did freshman orientation, how big-eyed all of you were and how the parents were scared that you were coming to Warren High School. I can also remember I made you stand up and then had all but 10 of you sit down. I told you to look around. And I also said, if you don't start handling business at this moment, this is the amount of people that will not graduate with you in 2020. My, how time has flown by. I'm excited to say that this group of seniors have proved me wrong. As this chapter of your life comes to a close, many more will open. I encourage each of you to make the most of it. Keep dreaming and be the best at whatever you choose to do. The class of 2020 has met all requirements set forth by the Arkansas Department of Education, so by the authority vested in me as superintendent by the Board of Directors of the Warren School District, I accept this graduating class of 2020 and declare them ready to receive their diplomas.
Robert Beauregard, Dean Castleberry, valedictorian. Valedictorian, Rivers Hope Frazier. Valedictorian, Mark Aaron Harrison. Valedictorian, Anissa Marie Henry. Salutatorian, Samantha Grace Evans. Salutatorian, Braden Cole Jones. Honor graduate, Wendy Duran. Honor graduate, Katie Renee Gold. Honor graduate, Ashton McKenzie Gorman. Honor graduate, Marshayla Sherelle Sabrina Haltewanger. Honor graduate, Matthew Arlen Howard. Honor graduate, India Elena Hudson. Honor graduate, Faith Lachey Jackson. Honor graduate, Ashton Lane Mann. Honor graduate, Carissa Faith Mormon. Honor graduate, Marley Ann Rawls. Honor graduate, Alex Russell Roden. Honor graduate, Diego Roman. Honor graduate, Joanna Salinas. Honor graduate, Ayana Levon Smith. Honor graduate, Ethan Lloyd Stanley. Honor graduate, J. Talia Sarah Watson. Honor graduate, Cade Adam Weaver. honor graduate, Emily Ann Wells. Honor graduate, Ayana Takia Wells. Graduate, Jaheen Jamarius Avery. Graduate, Kayton Ladarian Badger. Graduate, Blake Alexander Barton. Graduate, Cheyenne Summer Blankenship. Graduate, India Brianna Boswell. Graduate, Jaquez Marquise Boyd. Graduate, Kyron Lamont Brantley. Graduate, Chandler Von Calloway. Graduate, Yurith Campos Tapia. Graduate, Dakarius Marshawn Davis. Graduate, Trayvon O'Shea Duncan. Graduate, Aaliyah Summer Everode. Graduate, Dylan Scott Ferguson. Graduate, Matthew Gregory George. Graduate, Imari Leroy Hamilton. Thank you. graduate Jamarcus Malik Hampton. Graduate, Jaden Javar Hampton. Graduate, Jansey Raven Hooper. Graduate, Jonah Claiborne Hewitt. Graduate, Marcus Dylan Johnston. Graduate, Josiah Janae Kamau. Graduate, Akia Imani Kelly. Graduate, Jordan Elizabeth Kleins. Graduate, Lanaya Lene Landrum. Graduate, Thomas Edward Lefew. Graduate, Yesenia Macias. Graduate, Joshua Wade McLean. Graduate, Aurelio Melgarejo Gabriel. Graduate, Michael Allen Miranda. Graduate, Amaya Rochelle Moore. Graduate, Darius Ledre Palmer. Graduate, Elijah Pascual Cortez. Graduate, Timothy Jamal Phillips. Yeah. graduate, Cherish Sinise Poole. Graduate, Jordan Elizabeth Pruitt. Graduate, Ethan Scott Rankins. Graduate, Leticia Escamillo Resendez. Graduate, Sylvester Wayne Ridgel. Graduate, Jose Martin Rivera. Graduate, Sarah Cheyenne Rogers. Graduate, J. Talia Romero. Graduate, Serenity Marshall Smith. Graduate, Jamie Crochet Stallings. Graduate, Vincent LaRon Steps Jr. Graduate, Elijah Ty Lawrence Jethiodore Strong. Graduate, Alexis Nicole Temple. Graduate, Jose Luis Torres. Graduate, Nylea Deshauna Latrice Trotter. Graduate, John Luke Trussell. graduate, Peyton Kiara Wheeler. Graduate, Leslie Brianne White. Graduate, Brianna LaJoyce Williams. Graduate, Kamari Malik Williams. Graduate, Xavier Tyshawn Woods. Graduate, Taylor Elizabeth Woriak.